first time, well, I got on the bull, it didn't go that good. He got stuck and stepped all over me.
He was all scared and everything. So I just told him, hey, look, just pretend you're riding a horse. And then he went ahead and rode the little bull.
At the time, he rides the first time, and he booked it off of the bull throws on. And the bull stepped on it and everything. And I think it's the last time Arnold won a ride.
It was a ride that didn't go so well for Arnold Guzman. 2 years ago, he got on his first bull, and seconds later, he was on the ground. His dad thought his career was over, but actually, it was just beginning.
Well, I just went home, started thinking about it again during the week. I was like, should I do it? Shouldn't I do it? Then Saturday finally came, and my friend Gus calls me, and he's like, are you coming to practice? And I asked my dad's like, you wanna go? I was like, yeah, sure. So we got here and I rode again. And I fell off again and dad like started getting me more into it. So I was like, I gotta do it. I gotta stay on. Till the third time that we came out here, I finally stayed on and started liking it even more.
Arnold fell in love with the rodeo. He wanted to be a cowboy and compete in the Texas High School Rodeo Association. He had the courage to ride a bull, and he thought he was pretty good at it. But there was still one thing holding him back, his mom.
Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys.
At the first time, she don't wanna sign the forms, the papers. She don't let Arnold ride, and he started round and round and
Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys.
Told my mom that I had ridden a bull out here, and she's like, she kind of got mad because we didn't tell her anything about it till we got home. And then I told her I wanted to join in the club and ride in rodeos, and she didn't want to let me.
Cowboys ain't easy to love and they're harder to hold.
She never signed the paper, so this is almost like 2 weeks for the competition, and Arnold said to my wife, okay, if you don't want to sign, my dad has already signed it.
Long star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day.
So I finally got mad at her and told her to sign them, and she finally signed them, and I just started writing from then, but she wasn't very happy with that decision.
She wasn't happy until Arnold started doing well in the sport.
Because I wanna be a cowboy, baby. With a toddler back and the sunshine shining. Cowboy, baby. West Coast chillin' with the blues. I wanna be a cowboy, baby. Riding at night cause I sleep all day. Cowboy, baby. I can smell the beat from a mile away.
He was a middle school sensation, winning first place 10 times. He was a regional champion in the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. In the 7th grade, he also qualified for the National Rodeo Association bull riding competition in the junior high division. He has numerous belt buckles for his accomplishments. Arnold's mom is not only proud of his accomplishments, but more importantly, she's noticed that Arnold is starting to do well in school. The rodeo is doing more for Arnold than just providing awards for him to wear to school.
When for the rodeos, we have to be passing our 4 major subjects. And if you don't pass them, you don't get to ride. And like, I just study and everything and try to pass all my classes so that I can get to ride.
Yes, it teaches them that if they really want to go places, they have to get the schooling done. If they don't get their schooling done, well, that keeps them from going anywhere. If they're going to stop them from competing, then they start realizing that school is important. See, and that's basically what I try to stress. I try to tell them very simply that as long as you understand what's going on and you get your education down, that's the most important part right there. It takes you wherever you want to go.
Arnold's goals for his freshman year are to return and win regionals again, but this time in the high school division, and return to nationals.
I want to just practice a lot and make it to nationals in high school. That's like one of the best rodeos of high school there is. I think they're going to have it in New Mexico this year again. And Well, that's what I'm planning to do. Try to win the region and make it to nationals.
So far, he is off to a good start. He's got 2 first place finishes. During this practice, rodeo sponsor Frank Quesada gives all his cowboys a chance to learn, because it's not just Arnold who has a shot at going to nationals.
No matter how you look at it, you know, every bull is different. So they have to be ready for just about everything. So I put them in different bulls so that way they can experience different kind of bucks.
Nathan Lasoya is just in his 2nd year, but already he has made an impact in the sport.
My goal, especially for the high school rodeos, since it's my senior year, and it's the last time I'll be able to compete in the high school rodeos, I really want to do my best. I want to try to get first as many times as I can, or just stay on for that matter, and I want to go all out, and I really would like to get first place for the season. Last year I got 3rd place, you know, and it was still my first year, but I feel like, you know, I've learned a lot more, you know, of the moves, techniques and stuff, and I really want to try to get first place, and that's what my goals are. I'm going to go for it.
And there is Juan Alonso, a senior. Last year he went to state, and on this day he has no problem staying on his bull.
Try to go back to state for high school, and I hope I make it. Mm-hmm. You know,
what's it going to take to go back to state?
Well, it's going to take a lot of stuff. First, this has to, we have to practice a lot, so that way we can be ready for everything that comes out there.
And there is still one more goal for these cowboys, and that is to win the saddle, something recent graduate Fabian Salazar did 2 years ago. To win the saddle, you have to win as many rodeos as possible within the region and during the season. The rider with the most points wins the saddle. It's a prestigious award.
Took me a while to get my saddle. Took my senior year to get it. And what I did is just tried my best and came to practice and all Saturdays and during the week. Well, confidence is one of the things you need a lot in this kind of sport. Confidence is a number one thing to succeed, because if you don't have confidence in yourself, you're going to end up getting hurt or getting somebody else hurt. Mm-hmm. Because without no confidence, there's no win. If you have confidence in yourself and your guts and all that stuff, you're going to succeed a lot, and you're going to be winning left and right. Because I want to be a
cowboy, baby. The saddle, the buckles, state, nationals, it's all there for the taking. Arnold, with the support of his family and success at the junior high level, has a great shot at doing well at the high school level. Nathan also has a good shot at going to nationals. He plays football, and that has given him strength in his legs. He has already won a competition this year. And Juan Alonso went to state last year. He has more experience than anyone else on the team. Who wins? We'll find out many months from now, because the season is just getting started. I once was lost, but now I'm just blind. Palm trees and weeds, scab knees and rice, get a map to the stars.